A bold new procedure is giving hope to patients with paralyzed limbs.
It's a nerve transplant, which has already met with some early success. Eyewitness News reporter Michelle Charlesworth talked with the patient and his family.
You couldn't feel this at all, could you? And you can feel me touching you right there?
Yeah.
That's Dylan's mom, Maureen. And no, nobody expected such a positive sign so fast. A clammy right hand, a first in 16 months since the accident, is a sign the nerve surgery might be working. It took 7 hours and a team of doctors to work on Dylan Friday. They took nerve casings from the back of Dylan's calves and his mother's legs to connect what was severed when he flew off of his motorcycle.
In the back of my head, hit a street sign, and it pushed the helmet into the back of my skull, and it split open my head. And then from there, hyperextended my arm to the point that the nerves got ripped out of the spinal cord. And I woke up in the hospital.
Since then, he hasn't been able to move or lift his right arm or feel anything except chronic pain. Dr. Andrew Elkwood, his surgeon, explains the procedure and why he had to go into both sides of Dylan's neck.
I love the analogy of electric garage doors. One of the motors of the electric garage door is not working. So we go to the garage door next to it and turn the chain for both off the same motor. So we go to the working part of the spinal cord and bring it across. There are some working parts of his spinal cord on that, on the affected side as well.
What he transplanted were nerve casings, each about the size of a piece of thin spaghetti. That's what might allow the nerves to regrow and reconnect. All of the doctors and his family have their fingers crossed.
What do you make of your mom giving up the back of her leg?
Unbelievable. Shows a lot of strength and character.